With the use of iPads, we can have everybody engaged in analyzing the video. We have our subject who is going to display the launcher, and then we are going to make sure that they analyze. So the iPads allow everybody to be engaged. We don't have to worry about downloading video, uploading video. We're all going to use that video on the iPad app. In order to use the video physics app, we took pictures first, and now they're importing their video that they have. The video physics app allows you to put in axes. We want that lined up directly with where the gun is being shot. And what I like about this is slow motion, so you can see the dart actually coming out. Now he's going to go get the crosshairs. He's going to put it right where he sees his dart. He's going to tap on in between the crosshairs, and now that plots a point. The student is trying to delete a point, and we're supposed to be able to turn it yellow and then touch it, hold it, and then the delete option will show up. So once the student has the video plotted, she can click on the graphing part on the top, and then she can get the different graphs. If she slides that picture, she'll have different options. And when you actually produce this video, then you'll be able to see these at the end.
That's going to tell me what videos are available on the camera roll, you see? But I put a little white circle at the end of each end of the meter stick. And so I just set three data points. You're going to then fast forward it until you can see it come back down.